Hello, internet. Been out and bought another car. I'll show you around the car in a few minutes. I remember these cars being raced back in the 1990s against the Volvos and Ford Mondeos. There's a bit of a clue what I'm giving you there, what the car is. It's Italian. It's red. You've got it. It's an Alfa Romeo 155. Always liked these cars. Used to work at Fiat, and I used to work at Fiat, Alfa Romeo, and Lancia dealerships. So I pretty well know quite a bit about these cars and what they're like on the build quality. This one came up for sale. It wasn't really that expensive, and I know how rare these cars are getting, particularly in the UK. So I jumped at the chance of getting it bought. Massive thanks to the guy that I bought it from, because he actually offered to drop it off of me. I've just sold my trailer, so I can't get cars picked up and things now. So I've sold my trailer on. So this chap had a trailer, and so he dropped it off of me. Obviously, I've made sure he was paid for that. I didn't expect it done for nothing. But yeah, I'm really pleased with the car. The car does need quite a bit of work doing to it. Some of the paint work is peeling and the lacquer's coming off, so that will need sorting out. I call it dandruff. The car's got dandruff because the car's got dandruff because all the paint's peeling. Obviously there's going to be a few other issues. The exhaust has snapped and I've got an exhaust in the back seat here, so again, you know what, they clean the exhaust, it's not the original one for the car anyway. It's a stainless steel thing, so it's snapped the rubbers, so it's probably too heavy for the car. I don't know how long it's been on the car, but anyway, I don't think I'll be using it. I'm sat in the car right now, but the looking around the car, there's a bit of like particles of mould in the car, and you get a smell of deep, damp smell. So really, I should be sat in it, really, because I need to get some sort of chemical to clean all this mould. I believe vinegar does this. So I'll be cleaning the car out with vinegar, and also the interior as well. I'll take the seats out. I might even take the carpet out and give them a proper good clean. Because obviously, mould is not a particularly healthy thing to have in your car, really, I don't think, is it? So, but I'm going to show you around the car. And the mileage on the car is 109,500 miles. Which is really, for a 1996 car, is actually quite, you know, low in it, really. 2 litre petrol, 16 valves, so I believe it's the first time round. It's not a great, I can't see any rust on the car that I've been round the car and had a look. But the main thing, really, is just, it's just the paintwork. It's just really, really poor paint. I'm not sure what model it is. I know it's a 2 litre 16 valve twin spark. But that's the engine, and it's the model of the car, the twin spark. I'm not 100% sure, but there's the four clover leaf, which I know is another model in itself. But this one's got the badge on the back. Has someone just stuck that on? I don't know. It has got aftermarket wheels in it, and pretty reasonable tyres. But it's got the boot spoiler on there and the front lippy spoiler. So again, you know, all these little bit of extras, the sunroof, all these little extras. Tend to tell me that it's a pretty decent upgrade model, really. It's got the electric windows in the front, electric mirrors in the front. Well, electric mirrors in the front is the only way you're going to find mirrors, isn't it, in the front. You've got electric mirrors, leather steering wheel. What else can I say? There's no AC. That's about it, really. It's got, you know, the sunroof, like. It's got windy windows in the back. So yeah, I'll take you around the car now and I'll show you around the car. Okay, so here we are at the front, and you can see there's that little lippy spoiler there at the bottom part. It is quite badly damaged, which will need sorting out. It's got some bad cracks in it, particularly on the near side anyway. And you can see the paint. It looks like paint stripper, but it's just, look at the lacquer's actually peeling quite badly, but the paint actually underneath it is in good condition. Mirror's got damage on it there. This side generally don't look too bad.
damage there. All the paintwork, brake discs. They look okay. I walk around the back on the side. You can see there's some more peeling paint. Brake disc again, slight lip on it, not much. You've got the painted silt spoils on there. There's some more of that lacquer that's peeling. Another damaged door mirror. More bad peeling paint there. The rear brakes, again, they're not too bad, that's it, they're alright. A lot of surface on them. Fuel flap. Yeah, seems alright, not rusting there. Around the back, you can see that badge I was telling you about, this badge. So stuck it on, 20 by 60 valve. But bumper's seen some paint over the years, it's got some layers and layers of paint over it. There's this boot spoiler. That's got a dint in the boot lid, actually. I spotted this there. The boot dint there. A few dints here. A dint here. Let's look at the roof. The roof is peeling. Now we're have a look in the boot, shall we? Did actually find a nice feature actually in here. Open a glove box. I've got the handbooks, but I ain't got the the handbook that tells you what switch and what knob does what. I sort of found inside of here, inside the boot release. I thought that's quite quick, that's quite good, that boot release in the glove box. Super. Look in the boot. Generally, I'll get a torch. Yeah, and the boot looks pretty clean. A lot of soundproofing. These are the wheels that's fitted to it. These what they call dynamics, team dynamic. Got space saver in there, the jack. It's all in there. Yeah, seems to be all there. Obviously wants to go clean. I've got a good spare with it. Get the bonnet open now. Mm-hmm. Okay, here we are in the bonnet. Firstly, the bonnet struts are finished. I'm going to have to use a piece of wood to hold the bonnet open. And there it is anyway, the 2-litre twin spark. Looks like it's got a few oil leaks, a few issues on the rocker cover, by the looks of it. Generally quite... not too bad. Showing a lot of surface rust on the aluminium. Battery's not connected in properly by the looks of it, looks like it's been dropped in. Checking online, I've actually do noticed that the hydraulic control valve is a bit of an issue with these cars. So I'll get that looked at. It is, seems to be idling a little bit high. You can see the car's been stuffed for quite a bit. It's got a lot of surface corrosion on a lot of parts. You've got an interesting bolt shoved in the air filter box there. I can't see any crash damage. Everything looks pretty good condition. I'm glad to see it's got the original air filter box and not one of them stupid cone things on it. I'm happy that it's got that. It tends to lead me to believe that the car hasn't been used for, you know, race. Someone's been revving the arse out of the thing, trying to get more power out of it by putting another air filter on it. So yeah, I do like to see the original air filter box in there. But generally, the engine underneath there is looking pretty standard. Obviously, I'll be checking things like these fuel pipes. Checking out any leaks. You've got an engine stabiliser bar. Again, we'll have a look at that. All the electrics. Check all these things out. They're probably for Land Rover. So there you go, just a little look around this new car that I've got. I'll just show you around the inside of the car. I'd look under the engine bay, there's quite a lot of you can see the carbon stuff for some time. I mean, there's even cobwebs inside here. So, but you know, I'm not disheartened, I like the car, and I'll just show you, click inside the car, what we've got. So there you go. Here we go. We've got a simple dashboard. Got some little indicator lights there at the bottom. And sorry about the light, but I'm trying my best here. We've got some aftermarket head unit, a Pioneer one. Got a leather gear stick type thing on there. You see on top of the dashboard there's a few cobwebs, and we've got a bit of mould across there. I'm actually bringing in cobwebs across for me. There's quite a bit of mould across there. Dashboard. Well, this is quite a nice layout. You've got some oil temperature, and you've got the water temperature, and across there we've got oil pressure, which is quite good, and we've got the fuel as well. You've got a rev counter and speedo, and quite a number of warning lights on there. But also I noticed there's a lot of warning lights on the front here. You've got all these door opened and fog lights, brake light problem, and fan. You've got your clock there. I think it needs a bit of something not right there. I think it's sticking out a little bit in the corner.
So what I also did like about these cars, which I forgot about, is the indicator stalks and the wiper stalks actually illuminate when you turn them on. I don't know if you can see that. I'll do the ignition on. Let's put the ignition on. You gotta turn that off. You can see it, can you? I don't think you can, no. You got a dim control here. A little dim control, has a warning lights. So there you go. And yet down here we've got headlights. You can see there's more mould on there, look. Headlights, height control, steering wheel. The bonnet wall, bonnet pull is actually in a glove box, it's here. Which I might actually, has it been broken? Oh, I've still got the lugs on it. There's no reason why that can't go back on. This is the bonnet pull. So, oh, I've got to get that back on now actually. Let's see where. Oh, part of the bracket. The screw missing on that. Yeah. Where is it? There's a bonnet cable. And that will just surely slot back in there. Oh yeah, I can see where it goes. Set the cable out. There you go. That's it. Done. Fixed. I fixed the bonnet pull. It's a case of putting the cable back in and it went back into two lugs and snapped it back in. Job done. So there you go. Just a little video for you to see what my next purchase was. I'm filming this on Christmas Day. Well, before my friends and family come round, before I get me some Christmas meal. But yeah, happy with that. Just show you working it. There you go. There you go, it works fine that now. Along with this one. Yeah, that's alright as well. So yeah. Another little job done. They were open the bonnet for these things, they was. So there you go, thanks for watching, hope to see you in a future video, and you'll see some more little jobs that need doing on this little car. I've got another car going over. That works all right. Fantastic. Well, thanks for watching this video. Just a little busy video of my purchase that I just bought. Alfa Romeo 155 twin spark 2 litre. 1995, 1996, I think it's a 96.
So we'll see some more videos on this. Well, thanks for watching. Bye for now.